Welcome back. LIM Simple is an acronym for Life Investing Money and Business Made Simple. And the CEO, Ezekiel Shulesi, right?
Yeah.
Joins us as he helps us with simple financial tools to succeed in 2020. So remember, you can join this conversation, tweet to us at Plus TV Africa or at Weisho Africa One with the hashtag Weis, or you send an SMS to 081-8038-4663. Thank you so much for joining us, Ezekiel.
Thank you so much for having
now,
me.
I am so happy that you have heard part one. I didn't care.
Yeah, and that was amazing.
I mean, that was very, very powerful, yeah, man. And I know you do a lot of vision and those things. Yeah. Do you want to chip in a bit before we move it quickly to the financial part?
Yeah, yes. So usually what I teach, and I'm going to tie this down to finances also, is that people have to have dreams, goals. And so what happens to us is that when we're young, we think about our life based on what we really want. But as we start to grow old, we start to think about our life on basis of what we think we can get. Okay. And not what we really want. So typical example is you ask a young chap, what do you want to drive when you grow up? So I want to drive a Maserati, Lamborghini. Really nice cars, right? So that guy goes to school, you know, finishes, gets his first job, maybe he's on his third job, he's earning a millionaire a month now. He's checking online for his Lamborghini, $2.2 million. It doesn't hit home until he's like converted to naira, somewhere around 86 million naira. So he gets a good idea, you know, that the purpose of a car is moving from point A to point B.
It's not
that serious, right? So what happens is that when people get that, then they settle, right? But what successful people do is that take what they can get while going for what they want. And the reason why people do that is because we have a wrong thinking about how life works. A lot of us think that life adds, but life really compounds. Life compounds. So what it means is this, that no matter how far you are, you're closer to your future than you think. So, I mean, I have
a
point.
Say that again.
No matter how far you are, you're closer to your future than you think.
Can you elaborate on that, please?
So think about it. If you double one naira every single day, in 30 days, it's 10 million. On day 26, it still looks really far. But by day 30, you hit 10 million. I have a client who, between 2009 and 2012, were homeless, squatted with 13 families.
In Nigeria?
In Nigeria. By 2015, the business had done over 2 billion. Wow. 2017, over
10 million.
2 billion.
2 billion.
B,
two
B, with a B.
What happened?
We can't talk about all of that. We'll talk about that offline. It's going to take a lot more to explain. I'm saying that to explain that life compounds. Okay. You know, so especially financially, a lot of us, when we think about how much money we want to make or how much or the kind of things we want to use money for, and we say, okay, I want to buy a house or I want to do this. So we think we're so far away from it. But the reality is, once you put in the work, life starts to compound for you. It doesn't add up.
So what is that
life
compound?
Yes.
So we have to put it.
So let me explain. Right. As you go through life and you put in the work, right? And you start to do the thing. So the first work that I always recommend is first be clear about what you want, just like
she said.
Be clear about what you want. And the reason why you should be clear about, I mean, has this ever happened to you? You decide you want to buy a car, maybe a Range Rover Evo Black, right? Think about it so much.
You start to see it everywhere.
Exactly. It's like the association of Range Rover owners starts coming.
We start following you everywhere.
Now, there's something in our mind called RAS, Reticular Activation System. What your brain really does...
Reticular Activation System
is that it distracts you from everything else aside from the things that you truly
want.
Now, it's the same reason why you decide you want to go into broadcasting, for example, and it starts to feel like there are a lot more people around your life now in broadcasting than you thought before.
Absolutely.
So life is about recognizing than actually just working. So the people who don't, so I tell people that there's a science behind actually having a dream, because if you don't have a dream, what would happen is that you would not recognize the opportunities that would get
come
you
your
there.
Way.
So the first thing is to be clear about what you want and to put it in front of you. So the next stage that I always recommend for financial goals is, fortunately for us, we don't use checks a lot these days. So if you have a checkbook, write yourself a check. I do this all the time. I write myself a check. Yeah. My goal, so I like to plan 5 years ahead. So I plan 5 years ahead, and then I take 10% of my five-year goal as my one-year goal. So my one-year goal for next year is really pretty big. Yeah. So, but what's happened to me now is that my five-year goal, so I had this training in Ghana with a client of mine. They're billionaires. So I finished. I said, look, I need to do So I wrote down a figure. I wrote myself four different checks, put one by my bed, put one by my car, announced to my staff in the office, look, this is what we're chasing now. And it so happens that just within a short while, the opportunities to bring that is already coming. So you have to be clear about what you want and write it. So a simple example that I would give is that when I was in final year in the university, my room, I had a roommate that shared like an opposite locker. So if I open my wardrobe and he opens his, if he's standing on his wardrobe, he would see. So he wasn't actually reminding me that I used to write myself a $5 million check. This was final year student, you know, $5 million check, and I used to paste it on my locker back in the day, and he'd be like, this crazy boy, what the hell are you doing with this guy? Mm-hmm. So he calls me a couple of years ago and he says that I wished I did that too. Because I know that that's not a problem for you now. You know, and I said, yeah, because once you start to see it, what happens is that a lot of us can be as rich as we want to be, but just that when the opportunity comes, we either don't recognize it or we sabotage it. And that's because our mind isn't looking for that in the first place.
Could it also be we're just too afraid to seize the opportunity?
Yeah, no, but the thing is, fear is not a cause, right? Fear means that there is something that you don't understand. So why are people afraid to want what they truly want? Because they don't want to be disappointed. But if they know that life compounds and doesn't add, they'll be free to want what it... I mean, what does it cost you to want what you truly... You don't have it anyway. You know?
There's no harm in even wanting
throwing
it out there.
Yeah, you're down. I mean, the only direction is up.
Now, for the youths out there, basically, how do they strategize for the next hack.
So the biggest hack I know to change your life. So I tell people that the number one thing to actually change your life is not dream, goals, or these fancy things. And those things are important. I tell people that the easiest way to really change your life is to change your association.
Like yourself, people
change yourself. It is, take somebody who has absolutely no future ambition, no goal, put him amongst people that are ambitious. See, human beings, we are designed for community. That's why we define ourselves by tribe, race, country. We call ourselves something to identify with something.
I have a story to share. When I was in primary school, it's very interesting. I used to sit at the back, and my teacher, for some reason, thought I was very talkative at the back, and I wasn't doing as well on
as you shared.
And then he moved me to the front, and then I wasn't sitting with those people I was sitting with. And for some reason, I became more
very intelligent.
And I was doing very well. And that little example for me was like, you know what? In truth, your circle or your association is so, so important.
Yeah, I don't teach people to stand out. No, because really, if all of us are here and you're standing out there, after a while, you come back in because you look like the crazy one, right? I teach people to change who they're standing with.
With, yeah.
Right? Because that's the thing. If I want to change my life, I look at and like what Nika said, who are the people who are achieving these things? Yeah. And how do I deserve to get into it? Because sometimes
I'm happy you brought that.
Because this is it, right? Everybody knows that you're as rich as your average network.
Absolutely.
So what it means is that the successful people that are trying to get into their network don't want you.
They don't need you.
Not needing you is established. They don't want you. Because if you come in, what happens is that you have a chance of reducing
that
their success quotient. So what you then do is this.
You must find
a way to deserve the attention. And how do you deserve the attention? Everybody has something called circle of influence and circle of concern. No matter how rich you are, there's an area of your life that you have complete control. There's an area of your life that there's a need, right? So, for example, I have done a couple of things like volunteer for a particular person to do something so that I can start to learn. I have had the privilege of working with a couple of business people that do over a billionaire. I mean, tons of them, right? And yes, they're my clients, but I learn a great deal from them. I'll give you a perfect example.
You actually volunteered without actually.
No. This one's I'm making money.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm making money.
Volunteering for free, they're over.
So this particular one, I remember that I was having a meeting, and her PA comes to her and says something about, you know, food or something, and she got really angry, you know. And I was like, she said, look, my peer at any point in time would have a certain amount, I won't call them out, a certain amount with her every single time, because I don't want to hear about those type of things. And I'm like, why? She said, look, there would always be things to worry about. just make sure that it's not about small things. Because if you worry about small things, you won't worry about big things.
Big things.
You know? So for example, in the last 4.5 years of my life, I haven't had power outage. I went off the grid. Right? I'm not thinking about light in my life anymore. And my success quotient as reason, because I'm not worried about that part of my life. You know, I mean, everybody, when you're driving them, you know that particular house you check to be sure that there's light.
There's lights as well.
I don't have to check.
That's my house. Trust me. We're there.
You know? I'm not, do you understand? So, those, because there are a lot of techniques that you could use. You know, you could, you know, write your goals, do this. And all those things are great.
I need you to stress on that, because when you were talking about their concerns and, you know, a lot of young people today, I get tons and tons of messages of people asking me, oh, ma, please, I want to work with you. I want to work for you. And I know that this kind of work is burdening on me. Do you understand? Because people don't understand the power of this volunteering that you're talking about. They don't understand
if you're
power.
If you're young,
you know, everybody just thinks everybody thinks that it's about money. When you start to do that, you just kill it and you stifle that opportunity.
Yeah. Exactly.
So maybe you should hammer on that.
I've had to work. I've always been an entrepreneur, never taken a job, but I worked once for 9 months for free. And I tell people, look, if you go to an organization to work for free, you're not costing them anything, right? So they will give you whatever it is that you want to do, right? But the most important thing is that sometimes, why I decided to work for free back then was that I really wanted to learn. Because what happens that if you work for a salary, then you have to get involved in politics.
Yes.
Because why do people politic? So that they can get more important, so that they can get the next level and higher pay.
Yeah.
So if money's not a factor. And the thing is that a lot of us young people must realize that we actually do have time.
We do.
You know, it's, you know, there's the Instagram that's making people feel like they don't have time. The people that they even idolize and think that they made it early have put in the time. Davido started going to the studio at 12. He made it big at 18. We know that Whiskey started going to studio at 13. He would go to AJB's Jezreel studio. He would sweep. He would learn. He would sing. He made it big at about 18 also. 5 years, 6 years. So the people that we are idolizing, they put in the work. They put in tons of work. You know, so there's no escaping
they
the work.
They pay their dues, so
all.
It's all about paying
but the
your
reason
dues.
Why, yeah, but the reason why association is important is this. See, for you to really be successful, you must have somebody or a group of people that you are either too afraid to disappoint or too ashamed to disappoint. When you find those people, right, so that you can measure up to
the standard
that you would move. Because, see, we overestimate our willpower. Our willpower is not individual willpower, is not as powerful. In fact, science is showing us now that willpower depletes. You know, that if you exert a lot of willpower in the morning, you will not have that much willpower to, as a boss, to resist the secretary in the evening. You know?
Yeah.
So, but willpower, you know, depletes. But what we find is that why power and the power of a community of people. So that's like the easiest way I know I can teach and say, look, if you really want to be successful, deserve the attention, deserve the association of somebody who's really successful, so that you can now, you can take that person, become accountable to that person, and then that person, the desire to want to, you know, to be accountable to that person will change you. You will change how you think, you start to attract how the person thinks, you change your work. What you find when you find very successful people, they work hard. They don't work 9 to 5. They work like 9 to 24
hours.
You know? So if you're a lazy person and you get into the presence of that kind of person, you will work hard. You know, you don't need to be taught to work hard. Just looking at what's around and saying, look, if I want what this person has, I should work as hard as
possible. Where is the place for balancing different areas of your life? So health, I mean, so if you say work 24 hours, because, I mean, I hear this and I see this and I'm wondering, okay, but then are these people sleeping enough? Are they?
Well,
are
so, yes, so here's the thing.
Enjoy
I believe,
this wealth that
I think that our focus on balancing, I like to focus on pacing. You see, success is always a result of massive effort. It's always. Slow and steady doesn't work.
Anymore.
No, it's
really?
Never worked. Slow and steady doesn't work. If you are slow and it's like the plane.
Well, guess what?
So if you look at the plane, it has four engines. Yeah. It actually needs two engines to fly. But if you go slow and steady, it won't take off.
No way.
And it's four engines. So the thing is, once you, so what I mean by pacing is you need to know when to put in a lot of work and when to chill. So that's sort of how, so what you find, I mean, Bukwa was asked this question also, and she said, look, it's pacing. There is a time where she's full CEO, there's a time where she's full mother.
Yeah.
You know, so we have to learn how to pace, and that's what these successful people do. Now, some of them don't get pacing, so it then becomes a problem.
So, okay, so now, Ezekiel, I hear you clearly. There is that drought period, you understand? So help us walk us through that process, because we always know that there will be a time where the money is not coming. You know, what do we do at that time? Because 2020 is coming. I want to be financially smart. Okay. So I should know that, okay, yes, I've put in the work, I've done all of these things you said, I'm clear, I've written my check, I've changed my association, but I need to understand that what are the things I am doing at a time where I am still waiting. Before all of these things I have put in place start to materialize.
So
what do I need
to do? So it's two things. First is, I'm going to talk about the person who is waiting, but it hasn't blown yet.
I mean, something like that.
Still trying to blow. So you must understand that the time in which you're waiting, the question you should be asking is, at that point in time, is the fault not from me? Meaning, am I putting my best?
Okay.
Am I doing everything that I know how to do? Am I learning from people? Am I putting in the work? Am I keeping my energy up? Am I staying true? Am I focused on all of those things? So that's very, very important, because here's the thing. If because things haven't happened, you chill, you have to restart.
Wow.
So you just keep going like exercise.
So you have, it's like what happens when a plane is trying to, you know, to, if the pilot hesitates and loses, it has to,
it
has to go
and then
start again. So that's how it is. So that's for the person who hasn't blown. So the person is, so you have to give it full throttle, and you have to say to yourself, I'm going to focus on one thing. Yeah, I'm multi-talented, fine. Which of them would be most profitable to me? Can I focus on that for the next 3 to 5 years? And really focus on that. Right? That's for the person who hasn't blown. But for the other person who, yeah, you're in business and, you know, there's always times
downtime,
and seasons.
Yeah.
It's always important, right, to do what I call an expense, calculate your expenses and think about them long term. So, for example, how much do I use for food? How much do I? So I have this expense thing that I run people through so that they understand exactly how much they need on a monthly basis. So that in good months, because what happens to entrepreneurs is that they have really good months, and they blow it up, and then they have really bad months, and then they are worried, right? So, but once you understand exactly how your entire year is, you know, okay, this and this and this must happen, and then you can sort of be okay all year
even
round.
When there are down times.
Yes, you can be okay all year round, because every business has ups and downs. Even, you know, people in soap making businesses sell less in rainy season.
Absolutely.
Yeah, because it's raining, it's cold. People that take their bath twice a day will take it once or none.
Yeah. But food, though,
you know,
no season, you eat every time.
You know, the food, there's no season, you eat every time. Yeah. But also, when it's Lent,
period, yeah.
Muslim Lent.
Yeah.
I mean,
Christian,
there's less
Christian
food.
Lent, yeah. Too.
Christian.
Or even now that everybody is going
fit farm
and all that.
The types of food there, it will be different.
It'll change.
I have a question. And what would you say to the youth of today who believe that success is outside of Nigeria, and so all the Canadians?
Okay, good. I had a serious conversation with somebody a couple of days ago. So here's my take, right? I'm a business person, so Nigeria is, I have to be in Nigeria. And the reason is because my understanding of business, you know, is that a lot of money is made in chaos.
Exactly.
Absolutely.
And Nigeria is freaking chaos. I mean, the chaos here is massive. So there's a lot of money to be made. There's a lot of things that are not structured here that entrepreneurs can bring structure to. So I would, that's my own personal opinion. However, if somebody says to me, I want to get out and, you know, go
greener
out there
pastures.
And then look for greener pastures, I mean, the person should. He would go there, maybe find that it's not too green, come back, or maybe get there, maybe it's green for him. But my own thing is this. If you're going to make a decision, it has to be your decision.
Not the bandwagon.
Right? It has to be your decision, because what's happening is that once you get into I want to travel state of mind, it's a terrible place. Some people would pause their lives and over a 2 year period would invest in ILTS 5 times, and then by the time they look back 2 years time, they haven't gone, they haven't met the cutoff mark, but they spent 2 million naira trying
and
to get there.
They haven't achieved anything.
And the 2 million naira could have been used for something else.
That would have generated much more.
Exactly.
Income.
So I'm always very wary of people getting into that.
So Ezekiel, wait, before you leave, because we Do you have any free things that you can run for us that we want to help evaluate our financial
Like for
state?
Us here or for the
no,
whole...
No, for everybody. For the watchers. The
I can do something for us here.
Okay.
Yeah, and for the watchers...
we'll think of something.
Yeah, I mean, maybe I mean, I have a couple of things that I've recorded as okay. webinars and all that I can okay. always send.
Because...
if they send me a DM or...
Okay.
Or
yeah. okay. All right, thank you. I don't know if we have any SMS, but... But bottom line is, we would love to have you, because what we want to do is, we want people to be financially smart in 2020, not just go and, you know, truly people spend money, they don't know they spend money.
Exactly.
And they say they are broke,
no,
they are broke.
I'm about yes. to show you something. If you guys have 10 minutes
we'll
after
do
the
that.
Show,
you know what we'll do?
I'll
do that offline, then we'll post it on our page. People can go and watch on our YouTube page.
I'm not sure you want to post it.
Are you sure about that?
When we're done, you have like high blood pressure, stress. you know? I mean,
that's
all
the
that kind
reason
of stuff.
We should post it. Reality of life. You know what?
Yes, massive reality.
It's been an amazing 1 month. It's been an amazing 1 month. We are going to come 2020 power-packed and ready for you guys. You know, catch a repeat broadcast of this episode tomorrow at 3 p.m. And remember to continue to follow us on all our social media as we bring thought-provoking and engaging conversations to your screen. We promise that 2020 is going to be bigger, better, brighter, everything big.
Everything big.
All right. We love you guys. We'll see you in the new year. All right, bye.
Bye.